How's it going, everybody? This is Seth Isaacson for Rock Island Auction Company, here today to talk to you about another exceptional firearm in our upcoming premier auction, December 4th, 5th, and 6th, 2020. The rifle you see before me is arguably the finest Hawken rifle ever made, and it's also one of the earliest. If you take a look at it, you can kind of see overall, it's got a nice, kind of almost Kentucky rifle styling in the way the stock and everything's set up, except that it is a half stock rifle like the Hawken brothers are famous for. If you look right on the top of the barrel, it's signed J and S Hawken for Jacob and Samuel Hawken. It's in a nice silver panel. And unusually for a Hawken rifle, it's got gold bands at the muzzle. You can see it's got two additional gold bands back here on the breech. And then the rifle overall has an extensive amount of silver ornamentation. You can see all the furniture silver, the front sight's even silver. And then all the way along the stock, you've got a nice classic National Road style patch box with beautiful piercings and engraving. You know, the butt plate's silver. You can see the butt plate's got a tang extension that's also silver and pierced. You flip it over, you've got silver all along the side here, and then down along the toe plate, the trigger guard, and then of course, all the way along the stock. And if you look on the cheek piece, is arguably the most important piece of silver on the gun. It reads, G.W. Atchison, St. Louis, 1836. So George W. Atchison was a pioneering riverboat captain on the upper Mississippi and the Missouri River. And then later in his life, he was a riverboat captain on the lower Mississippi. And he was active from at least the 1830s into the 1850s. Earlier in his career, immediately following the Black Hawk War, he would have been running basically manufactured goods up from St. Louis up to like Galena where the lead mines were. And then he'd bring raw materials like lead and furs from the fur trade back down to St. Louis, which was a major depot of the fur trade and the lead trade in the time period. And that was a very hazardous occupation. Many of his steamboats met ill fates. Several of them sunk, some of them caught on fire. It was very treacherous. One of his boats, the Amaranth, sunk, and it was actually the inspiration for the same boat in Mark Twain's The Gilded Age, which features the Amaranth having trouble and sinking. And details on his life can be kind of tricky. There were at least two George W. Atchisons in the St. Louis area in the time period. One died earlier than the other. This George W. Atchison, we know, lived into the 1850s based on newspaper accounts of him actively engaged in the riverboat trade in that time period. 1836 is a telling date. We found that there is a George Washington Atchison who lived near St. Louis who was married in or around 1836. And if you look at the other details on the rifle, you'll see there's an arrow piercing two hearts here on the left stock flat, next to some interesting pearl inlays, which again, pearl is very unusual for, you know, an American muzzle-loading firearm. Here on the comb plate, you've got another heart-shaped piercing. On the patchbox finial, you've got an anchor, perfect for a captain of a riverboat. You could argue that this shape right above it is also rather heart-shaped. And then when you get down to the toe plate, which is nice and long, has multiple piercings, including two additional hearts. So when you've got that many hearts on a gun, you've got to wonder, okay, why is it there? So that's why we kind of started digging into it, trying to figure out when he was married. And we did find a George W. Atchison, George Washington Atchison to be specific, that was married in or around 1836. The dates aren't exactly clear, but we do know he was married around that time period. So that leads you to wonder, like, who may have presented the gun, given that he was, you know, involved in the river trade. He would have had a whole bunch of very influential, you know, business partners and people that could have presented to them this gun, or perhaps his new father-in-law. We don't really know, but you can certainly say that this would have been a very welcomed gift for a, you know, riverboat captain in what was essentially the American West in the 1830s. You know, we hadn't really pushed very far past the Mississippi River in that time period. When he was running up to, you know, up the Missouri River from St. Louis as well, that would have been basically into the frontier. We know Hawken rifles, usually obviously much plainer than this one, were used by mountain men like Jim Bridger. As I stated before, this is easily one of, if not the absolute finest Hawken rifle ever made. It's very exceptional. It's in good condition for, you know, an American frontier muzzleloader. It's got really nice, attractive, natural aged patina on all the silver. It's got some unusual attributes in addition to the ornamentation as well that we kind of want to show. If you look at the lock, you know, it's kind of a British shotgun style lock, and rather than having a cross screw that comes in from the left flat into the lock, it's actually just got a screw right here in front of the hammer that goes into the breech, and that secures the lock, which is kind of unusual. But when you look at the other side of the gun, you can see why, because that's where there's some more ornamentation that frees up space, and the lock is still nice and secure. So after Atchison owned the gun, we know it was eventually purchased by the Butterworth family in the 1870s. It remained in that family all the way up till just a few years ago. And for a while it was on display at the Cody Firearms Museum at the Buffalo Bill Center of the West in Cody, Wyoming. So this is definitely one of the most exceptional muzzleloaders I've ever had the chance to work with here at Rock Island. And obviously we've had a bunch of really historic, really important American muzzleloading firearms. But this one is by far the most exceptional half-stock percussion rifle we've ever sold. It's been a pleasure to work with it. Definitely check out all the details in the catalog. Come check the rifle out on December 3rd, our preview day, and then our sale is December 4th, 5th, and 6th, 2020.